Hi. Everything around us has been designed. The city we live in, the car we drive, and all the products that we use to start our day. The alarm clock, the coffee maker, the kitchen table, shower, toothbrush, and razor. We can look at all these designed items at three different levels or from three different perspectives. The first level is the what level. At this level, we look at the products as it appears to us. Products have all kinds of properties. The materials they are made of, their shape, their weight and color, and their technical features. The kind of things we can more or less objectively describe. Let us look, for example, at the electric toothbrush. It is wide, it has a plastic handle, a thin shaft with the brush attached to the top, a battery for wireless use. It vibrates and makes a drilling sound. It is waterproof, and you can drop it without breaking it. Based on these properties and features, we may perceive the toothbrush as reliable and professional, but also as maybe dominant and intrusive. As we can see in this example, based on these properties and features, people tend to ascribe all kinds of qualities or characteristics to the objects surrounding them. We can see a product as cheerful or cheap, open or inviting, cool or something for me, easy to understand or very complex. Through associations and metaphorical connections, people project these expressive qualities on products, and they may therefore disagree whether a product has a certain quality. Some may say this chair is very modest, whereas others might argue that this is a proud chair. Nevertheless, designers try to give these properties and qualities to a product for a reason, and this reason becomes visible at the next level, the interaction or how level. When people start to use or interact with products, they enter a relationship, just like two people who start to interact. In this interaction, we can see what the product means to people, what it allows them to do, and what experience it evokes. In interaction, we can achieve something, feel relief or happiness, get excited or feel seriously bored. Let us go back to this electric toothbrush for a minute. Through its weight and center of gravity, it feels pleasantly firm and stable in your hand. We may experience convenience when using this automatic device, but at the same time, we may feel a bit of overwhelmed or dominated. How can I make it stop? But why do we want to brush our teeth this way and use this electric device? Or why do we want to put a nail in the wall and thus need a hammer? Or why do we want to call home and believe we need a mobile phone? To understand why things are the way they are and why we interact with them the way we do, we need to look at the third level, the level where all reasons underlying a design come together. For the electric toothbrush, for example, people like comfort and convenience, or people want a healthy set of teeth. For the nails and the hammer, people want to be surrounded by beautiful things, or people cherish their memories. And for the mobile phone, people do not want to disappoint other people. People like to feel important. At this third level, which we call the context level, we look at all the reasons and considerations why things are the way they are and what makes products meaningful to people. These reasons can have to do with the environment in which things are used, with technical possibilities and physical constraints. But foremost, these reasons are rooted in us, in people, in what we need and aspire, in what we consider important and valuable, in our concerns and expectations. These various reasons or considerations are called factors, and together they shape the raison d'être, or reason of existence, of a design. Identifying these factors for an existing product or activity is a process of deconstruction. This week, we would like to train this process to make you see products not just as what they are, but also in terms of how we interact with them, and finally, as a result of a context, a set of factors that have shaped them and determined their why. If you manage to look at the designed world this way, you will start to look at designed things differently, and it gives you a sense of urgency to act. How this works, I will explain in the next video. First, it is time that you start practicing this deconstruction and do this week's exercise.